So what about salmonella? Salmonella species are very similar to those of E. coli. In fact, E. coli can be considered the big brother of salmonella, in that E. coli is a lot hardier in that it is able to survive harsher conditions, such as high temperatures, certain chemicals, and less moisture. In addition, if we say that there's E. coli present, you probably have salmonella as well. But this does not mean that we shouldn't be concerned about salmonella. In fact, salmonella is most infamous for chicken and eggs, rather than red meats and in the gut. In general, we expect E. coli to be present in red meats and salmonella in chicken. But E. coli is also present in chicken, as well as fruits and vegetables. So focusing on eradicating E. coli will address salmonella as well. Over the years, more and more research has been done on several different types of bacteria that are different from E. coli and S. aureus. They can also be considered as common food poisoning bacteria. We will address three more bacteria because they are uniquely different in a few ways from E. coli and S. aureus. Knowing these bacteria will help you understand the importance of the food safety pillars and the need to maintain each pillar. These bacteria include Listeria species, Clostridium species, and Campylobacter species. So what is Listeria and how does it cause food poisoning? Listeria species are most infamous for surviving and even growing well in refrigeration temperature ranges. These affect foods such as dairy, processed meats, as well as seafood. This bacteria can also survive in oxygen poor conditions, meaning even vacuum packed foods are not free from concerns. The Listeria monocytogenes is also known as an opportunistic bacteria, meaning that those that are already ill or have a low immune system are most likely to suffer from infection. Let's take a look at Clostridium species. Clostridium are bacteria that produce toxins harmful to humans. Food poisoning from Clostridium are associated with undercooked meats, often in large quantities, or food prepared from a large group of people that is left out for long periods of time. In other words, temperature abuse. Meat products such as stews and casseroles are most prone to Clostridium infection. What about Clostridium botulinum? Clostridium botulinum is infamous for producing toxins in tinned foods, which is known to be the cause of several outbreaks within 2007 and are of the most severe of the food poisoning bacteria. Let's take a look at Campylobacter. Campylobacter is one of the four global causes of diarrheal diseases and the major cause of human gastroenteritis. This bacteria inhibits the intestinal tract of warm-blooded animals such as poultry and are frequently detected within these farm animals. Campylobacter can be killed by heat and by thorough cooking. However, it is important to prevent such infections from occurring from the farm level. This bacteria is most infamous from chicken and has recently been shown that infections in the kitchen can occur from a simple practice of washing chicken in a basin. Campylobacter is able to survive in the droplets of water from the wash basin, meaning that this bacteria presents concerns during washing and defrosting practices. So much so that the international food safety specialists insist that you do not wash your chicken before cooking.